Well, we owe a lot. That's people of my age in Turkey, the scientists of my age, owe a lot to ICTP. Because when the numbers were low, that is the number of scientists, and when the funds were scarce, as were the leading role models, and nothing comparable to present-day ICTP facilities, which we have, we can have access to all kind of publications and knowledge, libraries were limited, then this was the sole window of the Turkish science system to the frontiers of world science, the frontiers of science. So we are most grateful for the kind of help that we had. And it also played a sort of a secondary role. It was a catalyst, but it also played to curb the brain drain somewhat. Because when people realized that they could come and visit this place, mostly in the summer breaks, so they didn't have to go abroad, at least for the sake of doing science. Some people had more profound reasons to leave the country, but at least not for the sake of doing science. So ICTP, again, played a very important role. Let me, okay, already 1 minute, more than 1 minute is gone. Let me go to the science system in Turkey a little bit. It's under the time pressure. It's a little difficult, but still, everything started in the 1930s, during that great transformation period, this so-called Republican Reformation period. So we owe a lot to that great man, Atatürk, that is. We didn't inherit much from the previous administration, despite the fact that Turkey was always an important entity in the European platform. But it was always setbacks starting in the 17th century. And the administration were shocked, and they didn't really understand what was going on, why it was always the Westerners, the Europeans, that is, gaining against, and Turkey was losing. Well, it took them about 250 years, and it was just during that transformation period they realized that what was lacking was the new method of R&D and knowledge generation through R&D, so that it spills over to all facets of life, from economy to welfare to military power. So everything started around 1930s. We had only one university and a couple of thousand of university students and a few dozen of faculty members only. And science and technology policy as a policy tool was introduced in Turkey in late 60s with the introduction of the economic development plans. And one immediate product of that was the establishment of a central organization, which is called TÜBİTAK, that is the Turkish CNRS, which I had the pleasure of running for about 13 years till I was busted off in 2003, that is, you know, through political reasons. That institution played an important role, and it formulated many things. It's, it created funding schemes for the basic science and the industrial science, which eventually led to the, helped in increasing the competitiveness of the country vis-a-vis the other things. The basic policy in the 1960s were promotion of basic and applied research in natural sciences, and in the third year economic, in the third economic plan, the concept of technology policy has been introduced for the first time. Eventually, there were a set of measures, several sets of measures, in particularly in the institutional framework level. Let me list a few of them. Public research institutes, firms, the CIMIDOS, the Technology Development Foundation, Turkish Patent Institute, and joining the TRIPS agreement, and National Meteorology Institute, etc. The point is the following. Well, promoting fundamental science is okay, but in order to have the spillovers to reflect on the economic level and the development level, so these tools were needed. Eventually, we had seen the outcomes of those things. Let me also mention now about some of the consequences. Where do we stand now? After all, many things which have been achieved. For example, the Turkish science system has grown really very strong. For example, as far as scientific output is concerned, number of publications in 1990, actually, that was the time when I was introduced to the Turkish science system as an administrator. It was about at the order of 1,000, and the rank, the world rank was 41st, and it was very low as far as the absolute value is concerned. It has increased to about 6,000 in 10 years, and the rank was 25th. Nowadays, the present number of papers emerging, originating from Turkey is about 25,000. That's an imposing figure, I guess. And the world rank is 18.
30 seconds more.
Okay. Well, so GERD has increased, R&D personnel is increased substantially, although they are still slightly around the critical values. And some of the international cooperation, perhaps I should mention, one of the important milestones was the Turkish entry into the framework program at the sixth framework program level, and we continue with the seventh framework program. And as the gross GDP is quite high, although there are some statistical manipulations, the amount of money we are contributing to the framework program of Europe is at the order of 500 million euros. So we are sort of a donor, we are in a donor status instead of this being sort of on the other side. And the Turkish negotiation with the CERN is going on. And I think next year the actual membership will be realized. And
I think I should stop at this point
because there are many things to do, but I cannot do it in 5 minutes, I think. Thank you very much for the invitation again.
Thank you.